Welcome to another Nucida training session about scripts and how to debug these. If you like, please give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to this channel and click on the bell to never forget our upcoming sessions. In terms of any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Today I present some concepts which are useful when working with scripted tests in TestComplete. TestComplete offers flexibility in scripting. Like keyword tests, you can record scripted tests directly. This can be a great starting point, especially if you're not well-versed in scripting languages. You can use a recorder to capture a keyword test's actions or use wizards to create keyword tests, which you can then convert into scripted tests. In TestComplete, there's a built-in code editor you can utilize to develop your scripted tests. It's worth noting that TestComplete doesn't have its own scripting language. Instead, it provides a range of helper objects and built-in methods. You can write scripts in standard programming languages such as JavaScript, Python, VBScript, and more. Now, let's take a closer look at the built-in code editor. Here, you'll find features like code completion, built-in code templates, and access to built-in methods. I'd like to highlight the Code Explorer, which is a valuable but often overlooked tool that can be effectively used for various tasks. To begin in TestComplete, let's revisit a key feature. In the code editor, you can initiate scripting by simply clicking on Record. Alternatively, you can access it through the script repository. Right-clicking gives you the option to work with code templates or code completion. For instance, you can easily insert a function and start customizing it within your script. It's important to note that you can also convert keyword tests, which are user-friendly and created through wizards, drag-and-drop methods, and recorders, into scripted tests. Through this, you can visually create a keyword test and then convert it to a script with a simple right-click. Let's take an example of this process. I'll add comments for clarity, and you'll quickly see how you can create the equivalent of that test as a Python method. Additionally, I'll provide examples of built-in methods, like waitElement, which allows you to wait for a specific element. This serves as a great starting point for scripting in TestComplete. One common question we receive is whether one approach is better than the other. In truth, it largely depends on your specific needs and familiarity with scripting. For many tasks, keyword tests are sufficient, and you can accomplish a lot without delving into scripting. However, there are scenarios where scripting becomes particularly valuable, especially when dealing with complex elements like grids and tables. In such cases, code offers more precision and control. You can map these elements as named objects and interact with them programmatically using built-in methods in your tests. I previously mentioned the variety of languages available for your use. When creating a new project, you can select from standard languages such as JavaScript, Python, and VBScript. If you opt to add a new language to your project, you'll encounter a slightly different dialog. Here, you have the option to include not only JavaScript, Python, and VBScript but also C script, SQL script, and JScript, among others. It's worth noting that while some of these languages, like JavaScript, have been around for a while, they may potentially be deprecated in the future. Currently, JavaScript, Python, and VBScript are among the most popular choices, with Python holding a prominent position as one of the preferred scripting languages for day-to-day tasks. In the code editor, when you're just starting out, we demonstrated how you can streamline your scripting process. You can create a new function easily by right-clicking or utilizing code templates to kickstart your code. For instance, you can generate a new function by naming it correctly and begin working with code completion. If you're starting from scratch and want to perform a basic action like logging a message, you can simply type log. The code completion feature will assist you by suggesting options like message or error. This makes coding more efficient and error-free. One useful feature is the ability to highlight a keyword and press F1, which instantly takes you to the relevant documentation page. The documentation is comprehensive and provides detailed information on all these built-in methods, offering multiple ways to access the information you need. Additionally, code completion, as demonstrated earlier, is a valuable tool that enhances your scripting experience. Now, let's delve into the world of helper methods and objects. These objects serve as invaluable resources in our testing endeavors. For instance, if I open one up here, I have several functions I've already created using AQ environment. Our helper functions are what we call AQ methods. Consider AQ environment, for example. It allows us to retrieve environment variable names, enabling us to access and use environment variables in our testing processes. We also have other useful objects like AQ file and AQ string. These objects empower us to work with files, file systems, and strings within our local environment. But the capabilities extend even further. We can execute anything within our project, such as a ready API test. In our ready API environment on the local machine, we can execute a ready API test directly from TestComplete by treating it as an executable object. Simply specify the ready API test's name, and it will run seamlessly. In addition to these synchronous methods, we can also harness asynchronous functionality. For example, we can import functions from other files, allowing us to reuse code efficiently. If callMeMaybe is another unit file, we can call functions from there to use in this one. Python offers us the flexibility to incorporate third-party libraries into our testing processes. However, a common question we encounter, which sometimes leads to confusion, is whether we can use third-party libraries in conjunction with TestComplete. The key to understanding this lies in the fact that TestComplete installs its Python interpreter when you install the software. Therefore, incorporating third-party packages is possible by ensuring they are installed using the correct installer and following the provided instructions. These instructions are readily available in our documentation. By searching for TestComplete Python third-party libraries, you can discover various helper methods and functionalities. For example, one such helper method allows you to execute shell commands. This can be particularly handy when setting up your testing environment. You might use a script like the one shown here to perform baseline setup tasks, such as configuring or resetting an environment. With TestComplete, you have the capability to run shell commands, like PowerShell scripts, to automate environment setup or other necessary tasks. This flexibility empowers you to efficiently manage your testing environment. Next, we'll look at an example of handling exceptions. For those familiar with scripting or programming in any capacity, you're likely aware of the common practice of using try-catch syntax to manage exceptions. The try-catch approach allows us to identify exceptions, log any encountered errors, take alternative actions to handle the error, and finally, wrap up the execution. In TestComplete, you'll find built-in methods and helper functions that simplify this process for you. Additionally, there's the convenience of code templates that automatically generate try blocks and catch functions, making it easier to implement error handling in your scripts. These resources can be especially helpful if you find yourself occasionally struggling to recall specific syntax details when switching between languages, such as from JavaScript to Python. Furthermore, another example of TestComplete's capabilities is working with files. We have the AQ file system method to facilitate operations like reading from or writing to files. On top of that, we have the capability to work with dates and times using AQ datetime objects and methods. This empowers us to perform tasks like retrieving the local time or adjusting it to our requirements. Recently, a common question arose about modifying the local system's time zone, which you can achieve using AQ datetime methods. Furthermore, here's an example of how you can create a local file using AQ file. Create. You simply provide a file name and then proceed to write data to that file from the system. This feature proves handy when you need to validate information or gather data for future use in your testing. You can store this data in an external file, easily accessing it later for reuse. Moving on to another often asked question, especially when API calls or influencing APIs during UI testing come into play, is about working with API interactions. In TestComplete, we provide built-in methods through AQ HTTP to create, send GET requests, and post requests. These methods allow you to not only make the requests but also examine the response, access different headers, retrieve status codes, or obtain response text. Furthermore, you can collect this information and use it in your local testing. For basic HTTP functionality and interaction, these methods are invaluable. Let me pull up an example to illustrate. When you explore TestComplete's scripting capabilities, you'll come across various helper objects that offer different methods for enhanced efficiency. These helper methods serve as your starting point for improving scripted testing efficiency. One important note is regarding Jira integration. While TestComplete allows you to automate interactions with Jira using the Jira object and its built-in methods, I'd advise caution. Automating Jira interactions in your testing suite can lead to challenges, such as false negatives and erroneous bug reports. It's essential to carefully consider the impact on your Jira environment and opt for direct posting from your log when necessary. Lastly, when it comes to debugging your scripts, there are several useful strategies to keep in mind. First, consider reviewing your keyword logs as they often contain valuable information for pinpointing issues. Next, dive deeper into your logs to gain insights that can help you narrow down problem areas. For more in-depth debugging, consider using breakpoints and watches. You might need to enable debugging in the test menu to access these features. Breakpoints allow you to pause script execution at specific points, while watches help you monitor variables and expressions. Additionally, the step into and step over options in dialogues can be useful for systematically traversing your code. Another beneficial tool is code completion, which suggests code elements as you type, reducing errors and expediting your coding process. Furthermore, consider using the rename dialog to create clear and consistent method names, promoting clarity in your scripts and maintaining an organized code base. In addition to these debugging techniques, remember to pay attention to your script's overall structure and the usage of comments. Striking the right balance in comment usage is essential for readability and keeping your code suite well organized. If you like, please give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to this channel and click on the bell to never forget our upcoming sessions. In terms of any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Happy testing and see you next time.